In this video, we'll be looking at the satellite page on the Garmin Montana 700 series. Here we are in the recreation profile, and we should see the satellite icon there. If you don't see this, you just need to go to the setup, and you should be able to find the same icon here. But we'll tap on it, explain the screen a little bit. First, we have our current position. We have our accuracy radius. We have our satellite rings. The outer ring represents the horizon. As you go inside into the inner ring, that represents more of a straight up, looking up in the sky kind of look. And you can see we are receiving a number of satellites. Each satellite has a number, which is represented down here. Each satellite has a multicolor, but you also notice here that we're receiving not only the American GPS network, we're also receiving the European GPS network. So what we can do here is we can tap on the menu, and we can do a couple things. First, we're gonna flip this to single color, and this gives you a little bit better representation here. If we're doing receiving two satellite networks, we can actually see which one's which. So in this case, the one that in the middle from the Galileo, you know, I would be looking straight up in the sky for this, as opposed to this one out here, which would be more towards the horizon or at the horizon. Now let's see what else we got here. We have the track up. This just changes the positioning of the rings. You notice here we have a north, south, east, west. Here is just track up. We can revert this back to north up so that the north is pointing up on the screen. What else we got here? We can do a satellite setup, and we'll do a deeper dive into the satellite systems, but quickly, WAS, your wide area augmentation system. This is a setting, depending on your area, you may want to use to increase your satellite accuracy. A number of years ago, this would be like turned on. But nowadays with these receivers, and of course now you have multi-networks that you can receive, you may not need to have this turned on, but depending on your situation, you may need to, but this is an option. Next, we have the satellite systems. Here you can see we have the GPS and Galileo turned on, but by default, you'll have the American GPS enabled. And one of the big difference here in the in-reach versions of the 700 series, you may not have the GPS plus GLONASS available, just because GLONASS is the Russian satellite network and in-reach is not available or not allowed in Russia and in a few other countries. So that might be a reason why it's not there. But like I said, Galileo is the European system, and we have demo mode. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to flip this to demo mode. And you notice the indicator up here crosses out, so that means that it's not receiving a GPS signal. And when we go back, we are in simulation mode. It's just keeping the signal that we received a few moments ago. And we could use this for demo or doing some stuff offline. Basically, we can tap menu. The reason why I want to do this is other options show up when it doesn't have a satellite acquisition yet. First, we have the option to actually turn the GPS on, and this will flick it to the default GPS network. The other thing we can do is we can set location on the map. So for example, if we wanted to make our current location somewhere else so that we can do a route or set some waypoints, that kind of stuff, we can go to a location, hit use, and then we have our coordinates updating, and then we can do some stuff offline. Other thing that we can do auto locate position. This is in the event that you have the device turned on and for some reason it is not able to get a satellite acquisition, there's something's corrupted, something's not working. We can flush the data that's in the device and force a satellite acquisition. This might take a few minutes, but as soon as you get a signal from a satellite, this option goes away and then you don't need to worry about that. So we're going to turn the GPS back on, and you can see it's acquiring satellites. We got some satellites now being acquired, and if I tap the menu, that auto-locate is not there. But if I had trouble, that would show up. So what I'm going to do here, go back to satellites, and I'll just flip it to the default GPS, and that will save some battery life using these two networks. At the same time, may affect battery life, so you may want to make some decisions there. And there you go. That is it. That is the satellite page on your Garmin Montana 700 series.